Thanks so much for joining us for this workshop featuring AOC Community Media's Social Media Accessibility Toolkit. This workshop is produced in partnership with the Lafayette Public Library, Lafayette Reads Together Initiative. I'm Christy with AOC, and I'll be guiding you throughout this session. I'll be sharing with you some tips for making your social media more inclusive of blind, deaf communities. Follow along with me today for some step-by-step tutorials for creating a more accessible online social media space for everyone. Our first simple and easy-to-do tip for online inclusivity is creating simple yet descriptive captions. Simple descriptive language will help individuals with sight impairments understand what's going on in your pictures. Typing this description out in plain language will better ensure that your messages are communicated properly. Avoid using lots of run-on sentences that jumble up together, improper spelling of words, or lots of cutesy code language with numbers and symbols in place of the standard alphabet. Another simple tool called alt text, which is short for alternative text, can be added to any image to enhance the user experience for blind impaired users on Facebook and Instagram. The text doesn't need to be very long or complicated, but it should describe at a minimum what the scene is and how elements of that picture appear and give some overall context. Let's walk through the process for adding alt text to our Facebook photo posts. It's super simple. Once you log into your Facebook, begin to create your post by uploading the photo or the photos that you want to share on your feed. Once your photo is selected, there's an edit button that will be visible once you're hovering over that image in the top left corner of your photo. In the edit menu, there's some other options there to crop, rotate, and tag your photo. There's also the button below for alternative text. Here you can insert words or phrases directly describing your image. For example, I'm going to describe my image as a black microphone lying on a white table with a red and gray logo that reads AOC, Acadiana Open Channel, Community Media. Another helpful thing to note is that alt text will only read acronym abbreviations for what they are. So including the full name of your acronym is pretty helpful for someone who just may not be familiar with your organization name or some common acronyms in general. Once you're finished describing your photo, click save and you are ready to post. Afterwards, you won't see the alt text in your caption or your photos, but you can always go back and find it using these same steps. When it comes to Instagram, this platform functions the same way. All you have to do is begin with selecting the photo that you'd like to post and editing it as you desire. Then, right before posting, you'll scroll down to the advanced settings option at the bottom of the page. From there, the option write alt text is visible. Simply click here and add in your descriptive words and phrases. An example of my description for this photo is a red studio room with tables holding a computer and microphones for podcasting. Once you're finished, click done, and just like that, you're helping more individuals enjoy the social media experience. Not to mention, alt text also works really well within the Instagram algorithm. So your description will help Instagram deliver your content to more users that enjoy seeing and searching those keywords. Let's move on to the next tip, using closed captioning for your YouTube videos. Including closed captioning within the video content that you produce and share on YouTube will help to accommodate hearing impaired individuals and extend the viewership of your creative content to this community. The cool thing about YouTube is that the platform already uses speech recognition to automatically create captions for your videos. However, while speech recognition technology is getting better and better, sometimes the machine algorithms just don't quite get it right. So let's walk through the process of enabling your closed captioning and editing the auto captions so that your message gets out to the masses crystal clear. First, you'll want to log into your YouTube account if you haven't already. Next, you can access your profile drop-down menu by clicking on your photo icon right there in the top right corner of your screen. And from there, you can select the YouTube Studio button. This will take you to your channel dashboard where you'll see all of your channel analytics and editing features. On the left side of your screen is a menu with the content option that we're going for. Go ahead and click there to be directed to all of your channel content. Click on the video icon for the video that you want to start adding your closed captioning to. Then head back over to the left side of your screen, this time selecting in that scroll menu the subtitles button. Now from there, there's an option that will be titled English or whichever language you're speaking, followed by automatic. If you select the edit button in blue, you may also see the duplicate and edit button like myself. Go ahead and click through, and when it asks you if you'd like to overwrite that track, go ahead and click continue. So from there, you'll get a pop-up box with automatic subtitles that were generated for you thanks to YouTube's speech recognition algorithm. But there may be a few edits that you need to make depending on how clearly the algorithm picked up your voice to text. So now I'm just going to go in and spend a few minutes fixing the small stuff, like the run-on sentences and any grammar or spelling hiccups. And if you wanted to take this a step further, there's also the option to fine-tune your closed captioning by assigning timings. The button on the top right corner there that will help you sync up the captions perfect with your video. However deep you choose to edit your captioning, just know that the time that you'll be putting in is just a minor trade-off for the amount of viewers for whom you're helping to improve the experience. Once you're all done, save your changes and you'll be able to see your accurate captions the next time you view and share your video. Now you may have to wait a couple of hours or so for this to take effect, but just remember when you are watching your video to click the CC icon on the bottom taskbar and voila, you are all set. For our next tip, we'll be discussing the use of the mighty, mighty social media hashtag symbol. Hashtags are used so widespread nowadays across social media like Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. So we encounter a lot of compounded words tagged together often. This can be challenging for screen reader tools to properly read out the words for people who are blind, partially sighted, dyslexic, and people with low literacy skills. The use of camel case hashtags can be a big help to solving this challenge. What are camel case hashtags? Well, I'm glad that you asked. Camel case is simply the technique of capitalizing the first letter of each word. It's called camel case because the rise and fall of the capital and lowercase letters kind of remind us of the humpback of a camel. You can use camel case to improve the overall readability of your hashtags. Here's an example of this. Let's say you wanted to use the simple hashtag how I see. With camel case, we'd write it more like this. The capital letter helps to signify to screen reader tools the start of a new word. And in general, it kind of just makes your hashtags easier for everyone to read. And now for our last tip, let's talk emojis. Emojis are like the universal language of social media. Everyone understands them, and often they help us to find the words that we just can't come up with at the moment. However, we encourage you to use them sparingly on social media and to not go emoji crazy. When screen reader tools encounter your emojis, they read the emoji descriptions out loud for people who can't see them. So for example, imagine typing out a string of emojis in a tweet like this and hearing them read back to you like this.
A grinning face, a sunglasses face, a crazy face, 7 smiley faces, 2 faces with tongue out, 3 party faces.
You get the picture, right? Multiple emojis are easy to see and simply ignore, but listening to multiple emojis, it's time consuming and can be kind of a pain for impaired users. As a good rule of thumb, try not to include any more than 3 emojis in your captions and don't repeat the same emoji over and over again. It's estimated that about 285 million people of all ages around the world are visually impaired. and of whom 39 million are completely blind. The accessibility of social media should be everyone's responsibility, whether you are an individual, a business, or a brand. Now that you have some tips on how to make your social media posts more accessible, you are all set to put these simple practices in action. And new social media accessibility tools are popping up every day, so always be on the lookout for the next helpful thing. We hope you enjoyed this workshop featuring AOC's Social Media Accessibility Toolkit, and we hope you keep up with us for more media tips and all things media production on our website. You should also stay tuned to the Lafayette Public Library's Lafayette Reads Together program for more events happening this month. Thanks so much for watching!